Hey everyone, I've been asked this question a lot lately. How many gears drivetrain can I install on my bike? And today I'm going to try to answer that simple question. In a nutshell, it all comes down to the options provided to you by the manufacturer of your rear hub. But what options do we have for the drivetrain? Since the 1980s, we've been using this Shimano freehub body, which was actually used by Shimano and SRAM for anything starting with 8-speed, 9-speed, that's a 10-speed cassette, and even all the Shimano 11-speed drivetrains use the same freehub body introduced again in the 80s. The sprocket orientation was dictated by this larger groove. However, one of the downsides of this design was that the smallest sprocket that could be installed on these cassettes was 11 teeth, nothing smaller than that. They were used both with QR 9mm axles and then with through axles, both by Shimano and SRAM at the time. Back in 2013, SRAM introduced their one-by drivetrains, and with that, the need of a wider range cassette. Welcome to what's called the XD driver that they needed for their 1042 cassette. Today, this XD driver is widely used not only for their 11-speed, but also by what we call Eagle or SRAM 12-speed cassettes. Other manufacturers took the design and adapted their cassettes, one special mention being E13 that starts with a 9-tooth cog. The XD driver can be used for both through-axle bikes and also the ones that use the 9mm QR, as long as the manufacturer of the freehub body provides you with the end cap as well. In case of Shimano, when they introduced the XTR M9100 12-speed in 2018, they introduced what's called the Micro Spline. This is a new freehub body that is needed to run Shimano 12-speed, and it's only available from a very few manufacturers today. So without getting into the details of road versus MTB, how do these stack up for mountain biking? First, the old Shimano freehub body accepts 8, 9, and 10-speed cassettes from Shimano, SRAM, and other manufacturers. It also accepts all 11-speed Shimano drivetrains, as well as SRAM NX and others. And finally, it will accept the 12-speed cassettes, the cheap options from SRAM Eagle, that's NX and SX, as well as other manufacturers like Sunrace 1150. The XD freehub introduced by SRAM would obviously accept the 11 and 12-speed SRAM cassettes, but today there's other manufacturers that use the same freehub for their options. Finally, Shimano Micro Spline. This is the 12-speed compatible freehub introduced by Shimano with their XTR, but today their XT and SLX offerings use the same freehub body. I assume that when they introduce the Dior, they're not going to use this and they're going to revert back to the old Shimano freehub. So there you have it, guys. Three freehub bodies, the good old Shimano, the XD driver, and the Micro Spline. And by using those, we are able to install anything from 8-speed all the way up to 12-speed, regardless of who makes them. And I really hope you found this useful. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. Don't forget to like the video, subscribe to my channel, keep an eye on social media, and until next time, I hope to see you guys on the trails. Cheers, guys. Cheers.